Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, who is also our chief guest, to address the audience. Welcome, sir.
Organizer of this meeting, Chief Reporter, Economic Times, Sri Ashwani, CEO, ANSR Consultancy, Sri Lalit Ahuja, MD, UBS AG, Sri Arun Kumar, Head of Business Unit, Bosch Company, Dattatre Gaur, Honorable Minister, Ganta Srinivasrao Garu, Honorable MP, BJP State President, Sri Haribabu Garu, Mr. J.A. Chaudhary, Pradyumna, other dignitaries, media and friends. I am very happy today. This is a very innovative program you are all having here. Now world is talking about digitalization and also disruptive technologies. In this context, you are having a meeting here. Digital disruption and innovation navigating the next generation revolutions. I am very happy I have gone through subjects also, panel discussions, minds and missions, fintech and the future of finance, big debate, digital opportunity or digital fear. I am very happy the way you have selected subjects also, very innovative and also very, very futuristic. I thank the organizers and also you are conducting this meeting in Visakhapatnam. For that also I am thanking you. In India, Visakhapatnam is the city, future city, happening city, most beautiful city. You may not get anywhere in India this type of city for various reasons. One is beautiful sea, RK beach you have seen. By seeing this beach, you will get energy and also creativity. And also next to that, if you see beautiful hills, you have seen greenery in Visakhapatnam. This is only the beginning. You will have fresh air and also to get fresh ideas. And also here, people are very good. You are safe. You may not have any problem. And at the same time, people are very docile in nature itself. Cosmopolitan, and also people are very, very good people. With all these things, I am confident Visakhapatnam will become financial and also industrial hub of India. It will be the best city in the near future. I don't even have doubt about it. But we are all discussing now digital disruption and innovation. You have to witness one thing. You have to compare countries also. Go to some background. China started economic reforms in 1978. India started economic reforms in 1991. Even after economic reforms in China, China has been transformed totally. Even if you compare some of the countries where they have gone, even Russia, if you can go through, Russia is having all advantages. Mineral wealth, water resources, size of the nation, you name anything, they are number one. But they have gone political reforms, China has gone economic reforms, then it has changed the total scenario. India and China, if you compare, China is 13 years ahead. We started economic reforms in 1991. Before that, there is single party domination, monopoly virtually, but no results. All over the world, people used to heckle us, Hindu growth rate. That is the standard growth rate we used to get, 2%, 1.5% maximum. When we started economic reforms, if you can go through all governments or single party majority in the beginning, then coalition governments, first time Narendra Modi got absolute majority after a long time, first of its kind. After independence, non-Congress government, so much of confidence on Narendra Modi, everybody voted for him. The first time, after a long time, we got stable government and also very, no need to depend on any other political parties. That is how they got clean majority. If you see here, for the last 1991, India is moving very fast. Even today, people are expecting double-digit growth is possible only in India, not anywhere in the world. No other country can produce that type of results. That is very certain. Even if you see further about India's strength, one is demography, younger population. Second is British. Thanks to British, always I'm thanking them. They left English to us. They have taken some money during that colonial time, even including our own Kohinoor diamond. It is from our place, from Guntur. That is that diamond also, it is now in London Museum. But they left English. That is one thing. Naturally, Indians are very strong in mathematics. That has become a deadly combination. Today, if you see Microsoft CEO, Nadella Satya, Google CEO, Sundar Pichai, PepsiCo, Indra Nooyi, you name, some people are here. You name anybody in the world, I'm telling you, in the near future, majority of the global companies are going to head by Indians. No other, that is a certain, it is going to happen in the near future. Always I'm saying, Indians are having very high IQ on management, technology, and so many things. Only the problem, so far, we didn't have that opportunity to prove ourselves. Up to 1991, no economic reforms. Anybody wanted to study also, go for abroad also, there are restrictions. From then onwards, things are moving. If you see, 1995, I became Chief Minister. I have visualized all over the world what is happening. Then I started second generation reforms to implement in combined Andhra Pradesh. Then I thought which is the best economy. Then I decided to go for knowledge economy. For knowledge economy, information technology is very crucial. Just at that time, there is a revolution in information technology, that is internet. First time I met Bill Gates in Delhi. Then I asked him, I wanted to meet him, I request his appointment. Then he said, as usual, normally, I am not meeting any politician, I don't have any work with politicians, mine is different work, I am a technology guy, what can I contribute for politics? Then with a great difficulty, I got an appointment. At that time he gave me appointment, he told me, why can't you join in cocktail party? Then I told him, if I join cocktail party, I may lose my votes, I may lose my image. I'm not interested in that. I want 10 minutes of your time. Then finally he accepted. Then he spent with me 45 minutes. What I have done, same vision I have given to him. India is very strong in information technology. Our people are very strong in software. This technology is going to have a bright future. India is the place where you have to work. By giving all the details, he was totally convinced. He told me, you are 100% right. I will work with you. Then he became friend with me. First time after Seattle. Then I went to Seattle, he came to Hyderabad. We met in Davos so many times. Finally, he started his operations in Hyderabad, first of its kind. Microsoft Development Center has come to Hyderabad. I had one desire at that time. You know, marketing is a big problem. Even today, marketing is a big problem compared to anything. There is a product, good product. Then you have to showcase, you have to market, you have to convince people that is the biggest job. If you get a company like Microsoft, no need to market. Everybody will think, Microsoft is going to Hyderabad. What is the specialty in Hyderabad? If you won't go, you will miss forever. That is the trend we have created, computation. Today, Hyderabad has become one of the most important center for knowledge economy. I had so many difficulties in Hyderabad to develop. Today, we made it reality. You know, from 20 engineering colleges, within 9 years' time, I enhanced to 200 engineering colleges. And also, I invited Bill Clinton at that time. I have named Cyberabad, the high-tech city area, as Cyberabad, to promote only information technology. We had two cities, Hyderabad, Secunderabad. Then I added one more city, that is Cyberabad. Today, Cyberabad is the most beautiful city. Total economy is happening there. That is how we promoted. Today, if you see here, this is a very beautiful place. Andhra Pradesh is having so many resources, new Andhra Pradesh, but we are having an initial problem. Everybody concentrated in Hyderabad. Then we created the best economy, all these things. But if you compare this Andhra Pradesh state to any other place, this is a wonderful state. Longest sea coast on east coast, 974 kilometers. Even if you compare Silicon Valley, it is better than Silicon Valley. Why I am saying this, all these people went to Silicon Valley, they are producing results. Now to produce results, it is very easy also, that is the strength of this area. Water resources are available, mineral wealth is available, and also gas, oil, plenty of gas, first of its kind. No other state is having this type of resources. But ultimately, now world is moving towards fourth industrial revolution. This is where I wanted to share some of my thoughts with you, all intellectuals are here, Internet of Things. At that time, I visualized software and also information technology is the crucial. If you think first industrial revolution started, even power, electricity was not there, it is only mechanization. Then second industrial revolution with the innovation of electricity. Then third industrial revolution with the innovation of information technology. Now I am very happy, first industrial revolution, second industrial revolution, it took so much of time. Third industrial revolution also, it took so much of time. Third and fourth, if you see, very fast. Now, technology, that is, if you see, IoT, Internet of Things. If you are, it is only an imagination. Once you used to think what is going to happen, Now it is all realities. We have shown our dashboard, how we are doing. What I am saying, technology, if you see, deadly combination. Now we are establishing fiber grid. It is only one idea, one innovation. Generally, our PM has given a statement, and also he has given a mission mode where to go, that is Digital India. Then I wanted to, because of my experience, I want to present before Government of India one project that is how to take digital fiber connected to the last village, last mile. If you go underground, it is costing 5,000 crores every home. If you won't reach every home, it is no meaning. Then they are working the project, not at sanction. Meanwhile, I got an idea by discussing like this. That is, through existing electrical poles, why can't you take one digital wire to the last mile in a first phase? It is costing only 332 crores. Gestation time 9 months. Now we have completed. With one decision, what you have to spend 5,000 crores, it is only 332 crores, 6 to 7% of your capex, we are able to do it. Now it is a reality. Now, because of this, we are working with so many companies now, how to get it connectivity. We are establishing Towers Corporation, seamless connectivity, and also we should not have any problem of bandwidth. Then we are working, we want to go in a big way, CCTV cameras, even commercialization, I'm working in that. And then drones is a big opportunity. Now if you use drones in a big way, with all devices, sensors, devices, everything, we can transform. Even biometrics, already we have started. Now e-office, e-cabinet, these are all the new things we are working. Even our friends have rightly mentioned robotics, machine learning, big data analytics, virtual reality. These are all various things we are moving in that direction. Now, e-Pragati, one of the most important project in dashboard they have seen. Recently, we conducted Krishna Pushkarams. Around 40 lakh people gathered for 10 days to 2 days time. We are able to conduct that event, one of the most efficient event, by using IoT devices and also by starting control command center. Satisfaction level is 95%. What it indicates, our people are very, very capable. But only the problem, we have to provide sufficient material, sufficient directions, and also empower them with powers. They can do wonders. That is what we have done. It has been proved beyond doubt. And also, recently we had drought. India, especially South India, we are having that problem. Even Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, they are fighting only 5 TMC of water. Even Supreme Court has given a judgment. In spite of that, they are not doing. And also, there was so much of violence in Bangalore also. You have seen all these things. So what we have done, how to harness rainwater into groundwater, how to link rivers, this we are doing. It is giving excellent results. Even ultimately, dry spell mitigation, we are able to innovate rain guns. Rain gun is nothing but mobile sprinkler. 1 lakh acres we are able to establish now through by using technology, uberization, all these things, even geotagging of all assets, everything we are going very cost-effective solutions. We are giving now 1 or 2 wettings wherever there is necessity of water. We are able to protect all crops. There is a technology. There is IoT, there is a process involved in this. We are able to do all these things at most efficiently. Today, technology of it is useful. Even all, you know, plantation is a hobby in India. Everybody will do plantation during rainy season. After rainy season, all plants will wither away. Either some goats will eat or otherwise it will be dried. Now I have introduced one program, geotagging of all assets, that is the plantation. We are giving a program. I am training my Dhaka women, and also I am encouraging people to go for selfie. Once in a month you go, what you have planted, how it is, you send a selfie. Geotagging or geofencing. Now it is working very well. All even 50 crore or 100 crore plants without cost, you know. What is the cost? There is no paper cost also. Automatically they can click it, send it, it is coming. Now this is where we are going differently in Andhra Pradesh. I am very happy you have seen all these things today. After doing this, India, we are using maximum cell phones. I called Microsoft. You are doing so many innovations. India is going in a big way for cell phones utilization. Future is only cell phones. Everybody is having device. Originally, I used it to promote cell phones. I used to ask my MLAs to buy cell phone. Now I am asking my MLAs not to put all your phones on off mode. They are not doing, now we are using everywhere how to control that, and also remote, what you call, we are putting this equipment to control all phones. That is the stage today. Even in the village, if you see, small people, even Shepherd Community is having cell phone today. Where is he? He is able to communicate. So many advantages are coming. Even my, recently I am doing 15 lakh farmers. I am giving them now cell phone with remote control how to on or off his pump set. I told them, I warned them, it's okay, I am doing all these things, but visit the field is important, otherwise somebody will take your crop. At least visit the crop field, that is how. Even Visakhapatnam, we are seeing today, all street lights in all my municipalities are going to be on sensor based. How ideas are changing, one example I'm giving you. Last 2 years back, Visakhapatnam was affected with the Hudhud cyclone. There was a severe damage. Then we lost all electrical poles or street lights. Then we got one idea to go for LED bulbs. Then I called Government of India organization, they came, we worked with them. By using LED bulb, we are saving power nearly 35 to 40%. With that, we had an agreement with them. Free of cost, they will put investment, they will take in profit on investment. And also they will give me, to start with, 30% what I am paying, they will reduce the amount. Then after that, how to manage service standards, for 7 years or 10 years, they agreed to manage the system. Immediately we got an idea, go for sensors. Today around 50 municipalities in Andhra Pradesh are on sensor based. Control room is in Amaravati. Every bulb you can monitor from Amaravati so that nobody can escape. If there is any bulb is damaged or burnt, automatically it go to service provider and also concerned supervisor for action. How much time he has taken also, it will be online. Today, some of the departments, either rainfall through rain gauges, groundwater, through underground physiometers, and our surface water, all reservoirs through sensors, even our pensions, real time, PDS, real time, power supply, all substations, we are monitoring real time. Even I can off, I can on. Even tomorrow, because of a fiber grid, we are going to provide 15 Mbps to every family, every home, institutions on demand based. On the basis of that, all TVs, internet, video, and also three telephones, we will give at the rate of 149 rupees per month. I can bet you this is the cheapest in the world. Nowhere in the world is available 15 Mbps for 149 rupees. Now, contents. We are working, so much of content is available. Video conference you can go. Once knowledge is available, if you can integrate, we can do wonders now. By using all these things, first year my economic growth, GSTP contribution is only 7.8%. Second year, I focused on administration and also I fixed targets for all my officers. Second year, our growth rate is 10.99%. All India, 7.5%. Third year, first quarter, our growth rate is 12.26%. All India is 7.3%, 5% more than. How we are doing all these things? We are very clear. We are having clear-cut targets using IoT, and also we are having all financial problems. Even in spite of that, by using technology, I got an advantage. My power, all top distribution companies in the country, 1 and 4 or 1 and 5. First company is Visakhapatnam company is number one in the country. And also Tirupati, another distribution company, third or fourth. My losses are 10.11%, 10.17 or 15%. Compared to all India, this is the best. So these are all the innovative ideas. We are using technology. Tomorrow, we are going to have every home 15 Mbps. Triple play set-top box we are providing for them. Now I can connect one wire to the electricity connection. Same existing meter. Real time, I can read the electricity flow. And also, no need to go for energy auditing. Every substation, DTR, even 33 kVA, everywhere we'll have these meters. Then real time, I can monitor total auditing, everything. Same house, again, water also I can put. One wire connection. I can monitor total water, how much water they have consumed. Even quality of water, I can monitor real time, where is the contamination. So what I wanted to impress upon you all, this is the possibility available. One example I'm giving you, how things are happening. Recently we had Pushkarams, I told you. During that time, I wanted to go for innovative ideas. There was a control command room. There we sat together. How to use drones, how to use CCTV camera, how to use smartphone, devices are there. Our people are seeing happily so many screens, so many places, pictures are coming. Just like cinema, they are all enjoying. But utility is not that effective. Then I called my people, we sat together. We spent qualitative time. Then all rowdy sheeters, I want to put it on cloud. Then I wanted to see through CCTV cameras. We are able to diagnose very easily. We demonstrated. Now we are going for DNA technologies. And also, one example I'm giving you, We had nearly 5,000 toilets. Toilet is the place where we will have so many problems because of every 5 minutes one person will go and use toilet. How to keep that clean? Then I asked all universities, we will send pictures. We will take every 2 hours one picture from toilet. It will come. You read, audit, and send the data to us, and then we will send back to the service provider or supervisor for maintaining this toilet. We started this type of work. Even CCTV footage also we sent for auditing. Immediately, our students got an idea, sir, this is okay, we are all talking about machine learning, we will execute it. Within 5 days or 6 days, I am assuring you, our students have put all the photos for machine learning. They have reached accuracy, 87% accuracy. Good, average, bad, these are all the three categories they have done. They have done extremely well within 4 or 5 days. What I wanted to impress upon you all, India is very strong. Our people are very strong now. If you give one idea now, our people are doing some research. Soil moisture sensors. And also they are going soil testing, real-time sensors and equipment. Even they are going, we are having strong base of fisheries, fish tanks. Pollution levels, they are monitoring now. They are putting cloud, what is the pollution of the tank, so that we will take preventive and precautionary steps. So we are going now e-Pragati project. Nowhere in India this type of exercise is going on. I am asking so many companies are here. This is the place, it is a happening place. Everything, now I have started real-time governance. What do you mean by real-time governance? I have to get information real-time, and also redress real-time, communication also in real-time. That is where we are working, it is possible. We are moving in the direction. So many departments are in advanced stage. I want to take further. Not only departments alone, I wanted to make Andhra Pradesh as a digitally literate state, digital state. For that, I am taking a big program to train every person to use smartphones in an effective way. We are not only going literate program, how to make literates. I want to make every citizen digital literate. Compared to literacy, digital literacy is very easy. Long back, we used to discuss with Mr. Rajareddy. Some of you are aware, he is professor in Carnegie Mellon University, one of the most respected professor. Then I asked him to head the organization, IIIT in India. That is what he is doing now. And also, at that time, we used to discuss, in India, how to reach last mile. Computerization, handling laptop, it is very difficult. Only touch screen has to come. Today, touch screen has come. For anything, even app, you can put your, only touch it, then information is coming. You can book tickets, you can do anything, you can go for anything. Now we are working with Kaizala, I told you, Microsoft. They have developed one app to start with. Now it has become a platform. You can create groups, you can create subgroups, you can send different messages, and at the same time you can take opinions also. Even tomorrow, 5 crore people at a time, I can send message. At a time I can take opinion, then I can take a decision also. This is where we are working. Even yesterday, today also I am busy. But only to encourage all of you, I came here. Otherwise, I am engaged with my MLAs, MPs, to make all of them as digital literates, not only digital literates, how to achieve progress. That is 3 days workshop we are having in Amravati, in university, that is KU, KL University. Work is going on very well. Now, all my MLAs, MPs, important functionaries, I can be online with them, real time, Kaizala app, I can take opinion, everything. So this is where we are working with our people. So ultimately what I am requesting you, we are ahead of others in technology. And also India is very strong in technology. And also India is going to develop in a big way in the near future. Growth will be there. By using technology and Internet of Things is a deadly combination. What others have done decades, we are going to do within a year's time. That is going to happen. Here I am requesting you, some companies are here. As you rightly mentioned, Visakhapatnam is the best place. You may not get anywhere in the world this type of place, I am assuring you. Quality of life, environment, people around you, the best. Technology, I can connect you both physical connectivity and also bandwidth connectivity for anywhere. The central place, from here, you can reach anywhere in the country, to the country very easily. From here, if you see, air connectivity we are establishing all over the world. Recently, India is growing at the rate of 18% air flight passengers. Andhra Pradesh is growing 60%. Exactly 15 years back, Hyderabad, we didn't have international flights at that time. Then we connected. Then we have gone for open sky policy. After that, Greenfield Airport. Now Hyderabad is rated one of the best airport. But here, better airport than Hyderabad, in Bhogapuram, we are going ahead now. One of the best airport at four international standards. From here, you name any country, you have to reach that country, direct flights we wanted to operate, not connectivity. Direct to destination also we are working from here. It is going to happen now. So, friends, wherever you are strong, we want to work with you on Internet of Things. You guide us, you are having sensors, you are having drone-related technologies, you are having CCTV cameras, not only using for law and order or traffic management, even road cleaning updation also I want to do through CCTV cameras. Suppose in a city there are cameras. Morning 8 o'clock I will on, send it to machine, read it, send the results back to supervisor and our service provider. This type of activities we can do it. This is where we are working. Wherever you are strong on contents, wherever you are strong on electronic classrooms, I want to go in a big way electronic classroom. Ultimately, every home will be a university. No need to go to university to do PhD. From home, you can do it. That day is coming now. Even PhD, not only regular students, even PhD can be done by farmer, by housewife, by a horticulture cultivator, even so many people for that matter. This is where we are working all these things. Even now, ISRO also, I am working with them. Best technologies available all over the world. ISRO is coming on 10th to Visakhapatnam. We are having all vice chancellors. How to use ISRO and universities linkage? They are having excellent output, but it has to take to the field. If they have to take to the field, students are the best community. Now we are going one concept. Every high school, every college, every department, I want to have incubation chapters, innovation chapters. everywhere. Every university, one society for innovation and also incubation. One society for incubation, one society for innovation. Every district will have society for innovation. State, we are going to have both innovation and incubation societies. Ultimately, I want to send all innovations, best innovations are there, to send it to the university. Every district, we are having one university, one collector. They will integrate both. Which are all the best for execution, they will implement it. Even it is better for commercialization, send back to university for incubation. They will incubate it. And then finally, we want to go for startup by networking with venture capital. Even CII is working with us to start one of the best entrepreneurs institute in Amaravati. There we can incubate and also we'll see how to put it for startup. That is the work we are doing. Friends, ultimately I'm telling you, what is Amazon.com? What is Google? What is Flipkart? What is Uber? It is only innovative ideas they have done. With clear-cut milestones they have executed. Now it all very, very successful ventures. Same thing, we are also moving. Uberization, how to do. Or technology, how to get it. Innovative ideas, how to implement. This is the exercise I'm doing. I can tell you one example finally. Everything is possible in this country. We had two rivers, so many rivers, among them two are prominent rivers. One is Godavari, one is Krishna. Now Kaveri waters, people are fighting only for 5 TMC, not 100 TMC or 500 TMC. Our Godavari this year, 2,600 TMC of water has gone to sea so far. One day, if you see, three gadgets, that is the biggest, and also people are talking, that is the wonder. They have discharge of water at the flood, whenever ultimate flood. 48 lakh cubics of water will be discharged. Our Polavaram project, what you are constructing now, 50 lakh cubics of water, even more than three gauges of China. That is the capacity. Then we are constructing that project. In India, in the near future, this type of project may not construct. There is no opportunity. Government of India has declared national project. Around 25 to 30,000 crores we have to spend on that project. We are working. All money will be given by Government of India because of a national project. We are thanking them. Meanwhile, I got an idea. We are having canals. We are having problem one end. Through lift irrigation, within 12 months time, I was able to complete the work by name Pattisima. By linking two rivers, it is the first of its kind in India. Both Godavari, Krishna, we are able to link. We are able to solve the water problem to a certain extent. With that success, I am moving further to link one more river and also other rivers also. This is the technologies are available. Today, if you go to Polavaram project, one excavator is doing 36,000 cubic meters of earthwork, 36,000 cubic meters, 200 metric tons, one truck can carry. Earth, heavy machinery we are using. So every machinery is available, technology is available, Internet of Things available. Only problem is leadership, how to execute it. If you execute, everything is possible in this world. We can create people happy. Poor people, they need better living standards. We have to create wealth for them. To create wealth, to eradicate poverty, best way to implement technology. And also if you use Internet of Things, then we can bring transparency, accountability, and wealth creation, ultimately empowering people is possible only through technology. I am very happy. There are some people, they are having some doubts. That doubt even we have discussed in Davos also. I was also a participant in that, and also I was one of the keynote speaker in that. Fears about digitalization, fear about Internet of Things. What is the problem future? Robotic will come, it will do all the works. What human beings will do? So what is going to happen, employment? These are all the concerns. What is going to happen, human sentiments? If you see some of the countries, Japan, they are having a population problem. Even Europe, they are having an aging problem. Even China, earlier they promoted single child. Because of single child, now all parents are becoming only wife and husband, single family. Because one daughter or one son, they married, they went, now at home nobody is there. So everywhere, if you go to Japan, they are having robots for serving. Even I have seen excellent robo in reception recently. Girl is receiving, she is talking. That is the robots they are able to bring it today, not only doing operations. Even at home, you can get it done some works. Even sometimes, there is a servant, there is a problem to guide him to get work, all these things. There is a robo, what all you say, it will be done. This type of problems are coming, but at the same time, no machine, no robo, no equipment, no IOC, IoT will replace human beings. Human beings are human beings. Even to handle all these things or to innovate all these things, there is human brain behind it. So we have to integrate that. We have to use all these technologies. It is a reality. We cannot escape all these things. If you escape or you are averse, then you will be the loser. We may not have that advantage. So what I wanted to impress upon you, India is a big country, big population, big opportunities for you for startup. And also big opportunity for you if you are having proper product to market. So in this conference, my people are here. Any innovative ideas, any innovative devices to add our ePragati project, we are welcome. I will be very happy to associate with you. We will work together. With this, anyway, today you will be here. Not only today, I am very happy Economic Times, they have conducted. Now everybody is coming to Andhra Pradesh for knowledge. Earlier there was a slogan, what Bengal thinks today, country will think tomorrow. Now what Andhra Pradesh will do today, country will do tomorrow, that is not far away. It is going to happen. Success will speak. Success is a, nobody can propagate also. That is going to happen. With this, I am thanking all of you. I wish all the best and also very happy stay in Visakhapatnam. Our organizers are here. I will ask them to provide everything. Beautiful tourism places also available. Excellent cultural teams are also available here. If you are having time, stay 2-3 days more. Relax yourself. That is also one of the most exciting, I'm telling you. Nowhere in the world this type of culture is available. If you go to America, if you go to some other country, there is a problem of human touch and also bond of family. Only the country where joint family and also living together is only India, because of our heritage, because of our culture, because of our history. It gives so much of happiness. You are all innovating so many devices. Devices can act, can interact, can produce some results. But ultimate happiness he is coming only through human beings, with family members. That is ultimate. For creating wealth, all these things will be useful. For ultimate happiness, we have to live with families. That is available only in India. I am very happy for that. I wish all the best for you. Thank you. Thank you, Ananda.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiring words. Every speech of yours is like a policy statement to us, and we try to catch up to it. So hopefully we'll have a policy for happiness in the near future from Andhra Pradesh, sir. So we are moving towards the last and the final leg of this morning session. So this the IT industry in Visakhapatnam, I'm sorry, in Andhra Pradesh, in fact, the industry people have come forward to form a single association. Earlier, we had many associations, many chapters, like Vizag had its own association, Rajahmundry had its association, Tirupati had its association. So today, sir, formally, in your presence, the IT Association of Andhra Pradesh is being launched, sir, and they're also launching their portal. That is the reverse migration portal, whereby they are encouraging, local talent, people from Andhra Pradesh, you know, who have made big in other countries to come back and, start working in Andhra Pradesh. So requesting you to please launch the ITA Association of Andhra Pradesh. Thank you.